this tutorial, I will talk about protection. What can you protect? It is possible to protect the system menu, the private flash memory, and the public flash memory. Why protect the system menu? Because in the system menu, the end user can change important configuration parameter, like here in the setting, the IP address, or change date time, change enable disable the USB port, and so on. He can do also critical operations like the upgrade of an application. You can prevent that the final user can do this. So how to protect the system menu? Enter in the system menu, alarm enter for some seconds, enter in the settings and change the password. Okay, I will set a simple password, 10000. Well, so next time, before to enter in one of this menu, settings, application, upgrade, logger, and diagnostic, the system will ask for a password, not when entering in the information, because in the information there are not critical information. All information are read-only, so not important to protect them. For example, to upgrade, before to be able to upgrade, we have to select the password. So if I select a wrong password, I want to be able to enter. Only if I enter the right one, 10000, I can enter. Okay. To reset the password, I would say, obviously, we have to set the password 0. So 0 basically means no password. Protection of the private flash memory. This feature corresponds more or less to the copy password in Montul. Why protect this memory? Because here the system saves the application files. So if you want to prevent that someone, your competitor, for example, installs his application in your Pico, you have to use this feature. The protection is active for all possible upload channel, that is upload via internet, via USB, using an upgrade package. So the concept is simple. There is a password in the CPICO controller and there is a password in the configuration, in the application, that is the configuration you want to upload. So when you upload or when you are uploading an application, if the password in the CPICO is different than the one in the configuration, then the system asks for the password of the CPICO controller. If you insert the right one, the upload continues, while if you insert a wrong password, the upload is aborted. Well, let's try it. Open the project. Select the configuration we want to upload and protect. Chilla for compressors. Well, the protection is here in the CPICO configuration editor. Protection. Here is the password. This is a 8 character alphanumeric password. I will insert a simple password. 1111111. This message states that once uploaded this configuration and once protected, once changed the password, I have to restart. I have to restart it. So 1111. Save. Actually, I have to edit also the network, else I will lose the IP configuration. Because if I leave use default and upload this configuration, I will upload not only the password, but also this. So I will lose the current IP configuration. So I will set this IP 10.10.1.2. Well, upload. So please note that the CPCon configuration, this one, must be selected every time. It is not automatically selected like others. So select 10.10.1.2, upload. So in this moment the controller is not protected, so the upload starts without asking the password. Well, I told you before that when you upload a new configuration, we have to switch off and switch off the controller. This is what I've just done. So now we can try two possible scenarios. I try to upload a configuration with the same password or with a different password. To try the first case, the same password, I can upload exactly the same configuration, because here is still 1111, in the controller we have 1111, so we expect that there is no password request for a password. Here is. Okay, skip. Now we can try the second case. The password is different. So we have a different password. We change the password here. So it was 1111. We change it to 2222. Upload. So now the controller is protected with 1111, the configuration with 2222, the password is different, so when I try to upload, expect that the system asks for the password of the controller. Here is. So if I am the manufacturer and or the installer and I know the password of the controller, I can insert it. So I try to insert a wrong password, any other password. It is checking if the password matches or not. Doesn't match, and ask again. So the right password of the controller is 1111. Okay, and the upload continues. Please note that I haven't selected this option, so I'm not uploading the configuration, so I'm not uploading the new password 2222. If you want to install a newer password, the new password, we have to select it and then upload and then restart as we have done before. Well, as last example, we can remove the protection. To remove the protection, we have to set empty here. So the previous password of this configuration is 2222. Leave empty here, empty here. This means no password protection. Upload. Remember to select this, so it will upload the configuration with the password not defined, so unprotected. 10.10.1.2, upload. It's protected, so I have to insert 1111. It is uploading the new application with the new configuration with the password not defined. So now the controller is going to be not protected. So remember to upload the CPIC configuration. Protection of the public flash memory. Here you can save your custom web pages, the upgrade packages, and it is a disk, so you can read-write everything. So, if you want to prevent that someone is able to browse the web pages or access to this memory to install, to copy, upgrade packages, or prevent that read-write any file, okay, you have to use this feature. So protect access to public flash memory via HTTP, because this is the protocol used to browse the web pages, and FTP, because this is a way to access to this memory to copy files. So you will see that once the content of that memory is protected, before to access to the folder using the browser or the FTP client, the system will ask the password and username. Well, let's see how it works. We have to define a list of users and upload that list into the controller. Okay, open the project, open CDesign, open the configuration, CPIC configuration. Also in this case, please note that this list belongs to a specific configuration, so each configuration may have a different list. Well, it is in the users, so we create three users: manufacturer, password easy to remember, 1111, service 2222, and user 3333. Okay, this is the list of the users. Now I have to upload into the controller. Okay, remember to select CPIC configuration, because it is here inside that I have created the list of the user, and upload. Okay, you have to switch on the controller in order to the controller use the new configuration. Okay, this is the disk, because I am connected to the controller. This is the disk. Ah, better, because I need it right now. Next step. This step may take some minute. So now we have to create in each folder we want to protect a file called htaccess or ftaccess to protect the folder in HTTP protocol or FTP protocol. So let's start with this one, HTTP protocol, that is protect the access via browser, basically. So that is prevent that someone browse the web pages. So this is F, so this is the disk, that is the memory, internal memory of the controller. The web pages are here inside the HTTP folder, so I have to create in that folder a file called htaccess. New is a simple text document, htaccess, is without extension. Here is without a file extension, so I have to delete .txt. htaccess, very good. Yes. And then I have to open with, this is a text file, so I can use Notepad. I have to write the list of the user, the username, not the password, only the username. So for this feature I can include the manufacturer and service manufacturer, close, save, and but not here, I have to copy there, so delete from here, no sorry, not delete, but cut from here and paste. Okay, this is the HTTP folder and here is the file. Now refresh. What's wrong now? The problem is this, because now I'm connected to the controller, the operating system has mounted the memory as a disk, so the web server is not able to access to the web pages. So I have to, as stated by the message, disconnect the cable, try again, and here is. So the web server has detected that folder is protected. It asks for the username and password. I apologize that the message is in Italian. Anyway, are the two typical credentials, username and password. I try with a wrong user credential, like user and 3. This is not one of the user allowed to access, so I want to be able to enter. I try with one of the other two, with the service, the password is choo, enter, and here is. So now I'm able to enter. So remember to copy the file, okay, the file in each folder you want to protect. Each folder may have a different list of users. Okay, now we can try the second feature, protect the access via FTP. So you have to create a file called ftaccess in the folder we want to protect. So without protection I can connect without password. So here is the content of the memory. I can enter everywhere. So let's suppose that we want to protect the upgrade folder in order to prevent that someone copy here another project, a different project, the competitor project. So I have to copy here a file called ftaccess. Well, Total Commander doesn't allow to create a file via FTP. I have to create it somewhere else and then copy. So here in the desktop I create a file, not a folder, but a file ftaccess, no extension. Okay, edit with Notepad, manufactu. Okay, that's enough, just one user is enough. So only I can log in only as manufacturer with password 1111. Okay, save. The file is still in my PC, I have to copy into the controller. So in order to be able to enter in the upgrade folder, I have to log in with one of this user. Okay, I can open the file because it is protected. So this is correct. Okay, so I have to log out. Try to connect again. And you see that now I see something different. Right before I saw three folders, HTTP, System Volume Information, and Upgrade. But since Upgrade is protected, this FTP client simply hide it. Hiding the folder, it prevents to enter. So, to see the folder, I have to log in using a valid username, valid credential. So, disconnect. Edit the connection property. I can log in with manufacturer and 1111. Okay, connect. And here is the three folders, so I can see also the upgrade. Final test. I log in as service. Service is not one of the list, and so the upgrade folder is hidden. Well, this exercise I used the Toto Commander as a client, but I can use also Explorer, Edge, FileZilla, and there are hundreds of different browser. And each FTP client has its way to define the password. Okay, now I'm not here to teach you how to use Internet Explorer as a FTP client. Well, before to finish, I want to unprotect. So login again with a valid credential. Manufacturer 1111. To unprotect, I have simply controller was not connected. So to remove the protection, simply delete the file, delete this. I can remove also the protection of HTTP protocol. So I have fully unprotected the controller. Well, that's all also for the protection of the public flash memory. I remind you that in the manual of Pico Sistema there are more information, is explained how works the protection, and probably you can find also some more information.